Hi, folks. Here we are at the Holston Conference Center. Rita's here, been here how many years?
22 years!
Yeah. And Richard Edwards has been here.
Well, I've been here off and on. I was here 7 years, now I've been back 3 years. I just keep coming back.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, he retired from the pastoral ministry to come work at the conference. So, yes. So this is where the bishop is sometimes and not where our district superintendent is. And so we just wanted to say hello to you from Holston Conference.
Hi.
Thank you
Greetings.
For supporting our ministries.
Very much.
God bless you.
So
okay.
Who is this for?
My church.
Oh,
I do,
okay.
I do a Wednesday devotion.
Okay.
Oh,
that's
Lord.
Cool.
I'm not going to put it on TikTok.
Please don't.
I don't know. We may be famous, Rita. It's great to see you.
Have a good
Especially day. If they have the time on there. I snuck out 10 minutes early.
God bless you. Hello, friends. That was a funny beginning. Usually I record from the national park so you can see beautiful trees and vistas, you know, from Gatlinburg, Smoky Mountains. But today I had to deliver my charge conference reports, or our charge conference reports. And so I thought I'd make a little video where I come for district meetings and for conference meetings. This is the Holston Conference Center. Can you see the words up there with the cross and flame, our symbol of Methodism? And it's in Alcoa, Tennessee. This building, I'm not sure how many years we've been in this location. Some of you might recall that we used to be out near Cokesbury United Methodist in West Knoxville. That's for the entire Holston Conference, which spreads from the tip of North Georgia through Chattanooga, Cleveland, Athens, Knoxville, Johnson City, Morristown, Bristol, Kingsport, Abingdon, Virginia, Big Stone Gap, Virginia, Wytheville, Virginia. We're all in that region known as Holston Conference of the United Methodist Church. We're named Holston for the river that runs through it. And there's a Holston Mountain included in this area too. So Holston's how we get our name. And so I just wanted to share a different kind of devotion today. Typically I give you the scripture for Sunday, and but today, thinking of charge conference, our connection, we are connectional as United Methodists. I wanted to offer a prayer for the priesthood. And we are part of the priesthood of all believers. So priests are not just Roman Catholic ministers, okay? Look in the scripture. We're part of the priesthood of all believers. And that means the laity and the clergy alike. Priesthood of all believers, all right? So our district office is located here only because the conference center lies within our geographical district, all right? The other district superintendents have offices in their respective locations in Chattanooga and Knoxville and Johnson City and beyond, okay? All right, so when the bishop is with us here in Holston, she comes here for her office, Bishop Deborah Wallace Paget. And then our district superintendent is Reverend Jason Gaddis. I turned in my charge conference forms to our administrative assistant for our district, that's Cheryl Thompson. And then you met Rita, who is the administrative assistant for the Holston Foundation, where we hold our, they hold our endowments for our church. It's a great foundation. And Richard Edwards also works for the foundation. You met him. He used to be pastor of First Farragut UMC and other churches in Holston, but he's retired, a retired minister who's come back to work for the conference. And so here we are in Alcoa, priesthood of all believers. This is from a book called To Bless the Space Between Us by John O'Donohue. To Bless the Space Between Us by John O'Donohue. May the blessings released through your hands cause windows to open in darkened minds. May the sufferings your calling brings be but winter before the spring. May the companionship of your doubt restore what your beliefs leave out. May the secret hungers of your heart harvest from emptiness its sacred fruit. May your solitude be a voyage into the wilderness and wonder of God. May your words have the prophetic edge to enable the heart to hear itself. May you find words full of divine warmth to clothe the dying in the language of dawn. May the slow light of the Eucharist be a sure shelter around your future. It's a nice prayer. So we pray that for our bishop, district superintendent, the camping ministries, folks are housed here, all those connectional ministries, the treasurer, the conference treasurer, and all those assistants that handle the offerings we send in, camping, finances, the foundation, the DS, the bishop, the call. Do you read the call? Our editor, Annette Spence, has an office in there and her staff. So we're part of the connection, and you're part of the connection too. And so thank you for your offerings that help us to be part of a larger church, United Methodist Church, which is global. And I think we're 13 million members strong around the world. It's always room for more, always room for more. And so I just wanted us to have a little different view or perspective today. And I saw some beautiful trees on the way through the Wares Valley section. And I don't know that the trees will show up. I don't see a lot of color yet. I see a lot of parking lot. But this is Alcoa. This is our conference center, okay? Conference center. And I'll leave you at peace. Today we lift our prayers before the Lord. And please pray for Evelyn Reagan. We were praying for her last week as well. She still needs our prayers for healing for her arm. And we think our own prayers and the prayers, concerns for those we love, and prayers for those we don't know yet, prayers for those we'd like to bring into the fold of God, the family of God, and prayers for those who have no one else to pray for them, persons who are forgotten, marginalized, isolated, incarcerated, for whatever reason. Let's pray for those as well. And know that others are praying for us. You know, we're never alone in our prayers, and God hears us. So, Lord, today we lift to you our Holston Conference staff, Bishop Deborah Wallace Paget, and Reverend Jason Gaddis, particularly as Jason prepares for donating his kidney to his dear friend, Reverend Randy Martin. So we pray for Randy as well, his healing, and all the staff. Annette Spence communicates with us. Tim Jones also is a conference communications director. He communicates. We'll see lots of emails from Annette and from Tim. And so we just pray prayers for effectiveness and for a winsome ministry and for productivity, success, good health, and joy for all that are part of our great United Methodist Church. And when we think of our church, let's always think of opening our doors and our hearts to more. Open hearts, open minds, open doors. Thank you. So that's our prayer today. We pray for you, for Evelyn and Lori and Margaret and Debbie and Don Muscat and so many in our congregation who need prayers, and loved ones of our members, and for an end to racism, and into homelessness and inequity in our world, and into violence. That love, the love of God will flow through our hearts, and where we see that there's a lack of love, an absence of love, may God's love just flow forth through us and through our church, and through our contacts, our connections, our ministries, to fill that void, because we are so loved. We are so loved. And we're grateful. And thanks to all who helped me fill out charge conference forms. Glad to get those finished. our lay leadership team and church council and Dennis and all of you. I appreciate that. All right. So have a great day in the Lord. And we always like to close with our the wonderful prayer our Savior has taught his disciples to pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Peace be with you.